14th, 1951, Madison Square Garden, New York. Joe Louis, former world's heavyweight champion, on the comeback trail, meets Lee Sebold, the British Empire heavyweight champion, in a scheduled 10-round bout. Sebold, with a white stripe on his trunks. Sebold weighs 190 pounds tonight, Louis 212. The former champion has a 22-pound weight advantage. Square Garden jam-packed tonight. A capacity crowd of 20,000. This fight was originally scheduled for outdoors at the Polo Grounds two nights before, but continuous rain forced two postponements, and it was finally decided to bring it indoors at Madison Square Garden. That caused a late terrific jam of customers at the box office tonight, and the fight had to be held up for a half hour. Joe Louis, the former champion, the great Brown Bomber, still popular with the crowds. He's been installed a 17-5 favorite over Sebold. Old-timers as far as the fight game goes. Louis is 36 years old, Sebold 35. Both have been fighting for about 16 years, so we're looking at 32 years of ring experience tonight. Round one. In the second round, Louis continues to control the action with jolting left jabs and hard hooks to the body. Now round three of this 10-round heavyweight bout between former champion Joe Louis, the Brown Bomber, and Lee Sebold of New Jersey, the British Empire champion, here at Madison Square Garden, New York. Sebold with a white stripe. Starting on his comeback trail, Louis lost to champion Ezra Charles. But since that loss, he's had five fights and he's won them all. He's a far cry from the great fighting machine he was during his heyday as champion, but he can still hit hard with his famous left hook, and he still has that pile driver left jab. Never been as hard a hitter as Louis, but Lee is considered just about as good a boxer. Sebold won 74 fights in his career, 53 by knockouts. He's lost 30, and he himself has been knocked out six times. Sebold won the British Empire Heavyweight Championship June the 6th, 1950, in London by knocking out Bruce Woodcock. Electrified the crowd in his last appearance at Madison Square Garden in 1948. He knocked out Gino Bonvino of Italy in 54 seconds of the very first round. One of the quickest knockouts in all Madison Square Garden history. Louis has been using good effect tonight. He's also using his 1-2 and his other combinations, hitting Savold into the body with rights and lefts and then coming up to the head. Savold's nose may be broken. Three. In the fourth round, Lewis's hard smashers open up cuts on Savold's nose and mouth. Now here we are in round five. Lewis's great ambition is to win back his world's title, which he resigned March 1st, 1949. He wants to be the first ex-heavyweight champion in all history to regain that title. Corbett, Fitzsimmons, Jeffries, the great Jack Dempsey, none of them could win back their former championship. If Joe wins tonight, he's going to get another crack at Ezzard Charles, the world's champion. Charles has promised to meet Joe again if Lewis beats Savold. To knock Savold out by the sixth round. This is the fifth. Joe hasn't much time left. Joe looks very good tonight. Best he's looked since he started his comeback. He's much faster than he's been, and his punching is very sharp. Of carrying his left hand low. Savold has been trying to shoot overhand rights over that low left. Savold shot that overhand right over Lewis's low left. Very weary, very tired out there. He's taken an awful lot of punishment to the body, and his face is pretty badly messed up. There's the end of round five, and Savold's handlers get busy on him right away. His nose is smashed, and he's having trouble with his breathing. Back in just a moment. Here we go into round six of this scheduled 10-round heavyweight bout between Joe Lewis, the Brown Bomber, former heavyweight champion of the world, and Lee Savold, the British Empire champion, here at Madison Square Garden, New York. Lewis's fans are very pleased at the way Joe looks so far tonight. He isn't the great Joe Lewis of 10 years ago, but he's a big improvement over the Joe Lewis who started the comeback trail. Sharper, much harder. He's been dealing out terrific punishment to Savold. throwbacks of old. And the referee warns him to keep him up.